Hi Pisces, my name is Sarah Tess. Welcome to this collective reading on this full moon tonight. I'm in the bathtub. I'm soaking off any yucky energy and making way for positive energy. And I hope that you do the same. It's always good to do a little bit of self-care, let your hair down, sweat it out, let go of those toxins, right? Be in the energy of going with the flow. All right, so spirit guides, ancestors, gods, goddesses, all in the right light. What is this energy for Pisces today? The mystic. Okay. So you might be a little bit mystical, a little bit witchy, a little bit into like herbal things, maybe a little bit like mystery. You might be a mystery to people. Like people don't really know you and they're kind of like, it's a little bit like we see surface level, but we don't really understand what's further. So maybe this is a time where you need to get out of your comfort zone and like share with people what's hidden underneath the surface, right? It's not all about the outside of the book, right? We want to see a little bit more. 111. It's time to dig deeper. What is this energy? Okay. We have wear your party hat number 15. Okay. It's time to celebrate, it's time to come out, it's time to be authentically you, show your stripes, you know, show a little bit more than just the surface. Like, be a little bit different, you know, wear something funky, you know, share more than just like a blank dark space. We want to see light, we want to see individuality. And then we have number 3, tell shame to suck it, okay? So if you're feeling shameful for whoever you are, if you're feeling shame for being different or for looking different or for whoever you love in this life, then it's time to get out of that closet. If people are gonna judge you, let them judge you. Honestly, people will probably judge you your whole entire life, no matter what you're doing. So really, is hiding in the closet the best thing? I don't know, is it serving you? Is it benefiting you in some way, or are you missing out on something that's really special, right? Number 3, so are you going to show your tail feathers and be wild and different and free and, you know, love your life to the fullest of your expression, or are you going to kind of downplay yourself? And I hope that you don't downplay yourself. I hope that you embrace what is, right? Embrace the truth that's in this life. Sing your own song, sing your own praises, allow yourself to be just to be, right? What does a Pisces need to hear? 252. You might be 25. 252 could be a part on the license plate, or it could be maybe your address or something. All right. I feel like you need to like sit down for this, or like you need to tell someone like you gotta sit down for this. Like, hear me out. Like, let's talk truth. So maybe you're sharing something that's a little bit real, raw, a little bit scary with someone, and you're not sure how they'll react. Okay. That just took a little dip in the bathtub. Gotta shake it off, right? Like, maybe something, you know, is like a little bit of a shock to the system, and then you dry it off, and it'll be fine. Like, it's all good. So, that might be how someone reacts when you tell them something. But it'll be fine. It'll pan out. It'll be fluid motion. Eventually, it might feel tight at first in the chest, and it's like, whoa, that hit me like a ton of bricks. But once you breathe, once you move on, once it kind of settles and grounds into the earth, things are going to be more fluid, and you're going to be more open and able to be authentically you in your fullest expression, right? This is like really yummy energy. You want to be able to shine from the heart, shine from within. I know that I am the only person who can bring forth that creative, oh my god, my throat, okay, try again. I know that I am the only person who can bring forth the creativity that lives in my body. I am magic. Yep, you're magic. 427 is the number that I'm seeing. You might be 27, you might be born on 427, or 427 is a really important date, so April 27th. One card, please, for Pisces, 444. One card for Pisces. I feel like it's like slow burn energy. It's like, this is the slowest thing ever. Like, can you hurry your story up? Maybe that's how someone's feeling, or maybe you're feeling like whatever story you're telling is like not going to plan, or it's like slower than you think. You're not getting out the point of it. Something like that. It's like you're not sure that people are actually hearing you. Like, they might be listening, but you're not sure if they're actually hearing you. Yeah. Okay. This is number 29. This is birth energy. So you're birthing something new. You're being real. You're being raw. You're being open. You're turning into a beautiful butterfly, and you're sharing that positive lotus, like blooming energy out there. And when you do open up and you share the authenticity, you're really scared that people are not going to take it in a positive way. But I think that you are honestly holding yourself back. I think that whatever is going to come out of you is going to be really beautiful and positive. And I think that you just need to allow yourself to see it through. You could even be pregnant. All right, one card please for Pisces. One card, please, for Pisces. Slow and steady wins the race. I do definitely feel like you're pregnant, or maybe you're pregnant, or with kid, with a. Apparently, I'm thinking you're pregnant. Okay, so divine destiny, yeah. You found your significant other, and maybe y'all are talking about kids, or one of you wants kids and the other one isn't sure. I think that you need to allow yourself to turn inwards, tap into your intuition, and talk to your spirit guides, talk to yourself, you know, sit with things, ground down that energy, and figure out how you're going to move through a certain situation with grace, love, and compassion for yourself and for all the parties involved. And I think that that's also when you show yourself the respect of giving yourself grace, love, compassion, forgiveness, whatever, what have you, you're going to do the same thing and open up the space for others to look at you in the same way. Like, if you were to look at yourself in shame, then people are probably going to look at you in shame. It's all about perspective. It's all about what you're putting out there. So if you're loving the situation, if you're looking at it in a really positive, beautiful way, then people will also do the same thing. So maybe this is an unplanned pregnancy or something like that, and it's like a little bit of a shock to you, maybe a shock to a partner, shock to the family, whatever it is, just allow yourself to look at it in a really vibrant, positive energy and try to find the little snippets of positive yumminess within, because you can always turn a negative idea into a positive situation. So change that perspective out and kind of shift in newer, more vibrant energy and just allow things to flow naturally. And really move through a place of love. That's the main thing here. Yeah, move through a place of love, move through compassion, move through heart-centered space of, I love you, I got this, you know, like tell yourself those things that you need to hear to make the situation the best it can be for you and for whoever all is involved. And I feel like there is some tight energy in your solar plexus, your willpower space. So maybe you need to go get some sunshine, tap into yellow energy, yellow orange energy, and really push yourself to your edge in terms of willpower and inner strength, because you're stronger than you know, and you can handle everything in this life that you set your mind to. So allow yourself the opportunity to see things through and to see things in different eyes. All right, stay strong. You got this. It'll be okay. Thank you so much for being here. If you enjoyed this reading, please like, comment if you'd like below, and also subscribe if you're new. Thank you so much, and I'll see you soon. Bye.